Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. This is Samar from the Naqabi Diaries, and I'm reading this book, The Ideal Muslimah. I'll link for the PDF version in the description box, inshallah. So we're on the chapter 5 now, which is the Muslim woman and her children. And this segment is, she understands the great responsibility that she has towards her children. And I'd just like to read this hadith of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He said, beware, each of you is a shepherd, and each of you is responsible and answerable for his flock. The leader and the ruler is a shepherd over the people, and shall be questioned about his subjects and as to how he conducted their affairs. A man is a guardian over his family, and shall be questioned about them as to how he looked after their physical and moral well-being. A woman is the guardian over the household of her husband and his children, and shall be questioned about them as to how she managed the household and brought up the children. A servant is the shepherd of his master's property, and shall be questioned about it as to how he safeguarded his trust. Beware, every one of you is a guardian, and every one of you shall be questioned with regard to his trust upon Allah. So this obviously points to how important the role of the mother is. We shouldn't think that because our husbands are above us in regards to responsibility and leading the home itself, that this means that we as women are, you know, allowed to just lay back and, you know, neglect this kind of responsibility as you know, when it comes to actually raising the children and being hands-on. And it's not just, you know, down to taking care of them, cooking their food and cleaning them up after they've, you know, messed themselves or whatever. It's not just as simple as that, sisters. It's a lot more than that, sisters. It's about instilling in them, you know, the good manners and religious practices, subhanAllah, such as eating with the right hand. And that goes for if your child is left-handed or right-handed. And, you know, I have children, and one of them is right-handed and one of them is left-handed. And alhamdulillah, my daughter, she's left-handed, and she has no problems with eating with her right hand. So these are the things that you instill in your child from a young age, from as soon as they're able to eat. You know, as soon as they start feeding themselves, you just start training them, and it becomes second nature to them. So we don't realize the effect that our training from a very young age has on our children. And definitely, with the correct mindset, anybody can learn anything at any age. But there's no doubt about the fact that as the younger that you are, the easier it is to pick up certain habits and to let them be ingrained in your, you know, your psychology, your mental state, so that it's naturally easy for you to do those things. So this is why it's so important for us to make as much effort as possible to be consistent in training our children from the youngest ages possible. As soon as they're able to do anything, subhanAllah, these small things which are sunnahs for us to do, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he's commanded us, we shouldn't downplay these things. We should make sure and to give them the most importance, so that our children will find those things easy when they become adults. It will be something that they don't even think about, subhanAllah, but they know that this is part of the sunnah. They have been raised as Muslims. They can be identified as Muslims from the physical actions, the way that they eat, the way that they drink, the way that they talk, the way that they sit, the way that they even dress themselves, subhanAllah. These things are very important. So we have, as mothers, a greater influence on our children even than their fathers do, because naturally we're the ones who spend most time with them. And not only that, sisters, but I would like to point out that the mother, we have a greater capacity in some respects to understand the nature of our children and how they think. And subhanAllah, this is something very interesting. As women, when you have a child, and especially when you breastfeed that child and you're rearing that child from its early days, you know, you can see, and the mother understands the differences in character between her children, subhanAllah. So when we have children who have different personalities and different characters, we also need to treat them and raise them and train them according to those personalities and characters, because it's not a one size fits all with our children. Some of them, we will find that certain things is easy to teach them, while others it will be more challenging and more difficult. And this is partly to do with how we understand their characters. So we need to be flexible with our training and our teaching, and think about creative ways to make it easy for our children to learn certain things that we're trying to teach them, rather than, you know, trying to force a specific way of teaching onto one, when it is not that in their natural kind of way to accept that, subhanAllah. So there's so many things involved with raising children, which is very interesting. And here I like the fact that it's mentioned in this chapter many pious and righteous and noble men who were raised primarily by their mothers. Some of them were single mothers too, subhanAllah, but it mentioned the virtue of their mothers and how they have raised these men, subhanAllah. So we have so many examples in our Muslim history of men who were, you know, who were amazing and noble men who came to that point as the result of having mothers who were, subhanAllah, they were on the ball, basically. They were on their game. They knew that they were trying to raise, you know, real men, subhanAllah. So some of the examples here is given Zubair ibn al-Awam, and his mother is Safiya bint Abdul Muttalib. We have Abdullah, Mundir ibn and Urwa, the sons of Zubair, and they are the sons of Asma bint Abi Bakr, radiallahu anhuma. We have Ali ibn Abi Talib, and his mother was Fatima bint Asad. Abdullah bin Jafir, and his mother was Asma bint Umais. We have Muawiyah ibn Abi Sufyan, and his mother was Hind bint Utba. So there's many women who are mentioned here who had such strong characters, and they instilled that, you know, that strong character and nobility into their sons as well, subhanAllah. Alhamdulillah for everything. Anything that I've said which is incorrect is from myself, and anything that I've said which is correct is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah knows best. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.